If you see some parties, you can actually tell who their president is going to be in the next 20 years. You know their president for the last 20 years, and you're pretty clear that for the next 20 years, it's going to be a son or a daughter of that particular family who will take over the presidency of that party. Now, when you don't give space to talent within the political system, what happens is that the system becomes a closed system. The system perpetrates this sense of feudalism. It perpetrates the sense of rewarding only those who are close to a particular family or a dynasty. And that's how nepotism takes over in the entire system rather than meritocracy taking over. Therefore, I feel that the only way to actually push meritocracy in India is to push meritocracy in politics. And that can happen by allowing young, talented people who don't have family backgrounds into politics, by allowing them to come into parliament, by allowing them to come into assemblies, by allowing them to become the decision makers. Because once they are in the power and once they make the decisions for the entire country, they will ensure that the narrative should be that those who are performing, those who are kamdars, should triumph over the namdars. Let me give you a small example of this. Let's assume that tomorrow the election commission decides that they're going to sort out the election rules and ensure that everybody can have a level playing field. That means that there's going to be a specific amount that can be spent on election finances, there's a specific amount that can be spent on campaigning, and they make the playing field more equal. Now, when you have a parliament which has space for people who are only elected because they are able to serve the people, they're able to convince the people, not because of what their father or their grandmother or their grandfather did, but what they will do for the people for the next 5 years, they will be tested on the basis of their ability, on the basis of their accountability, on the basis of their talent, and on the basis of how many promises they've managed to keep. And when that happens, they'll be forced to deliver. But when the system is a feudal system, people know inherently that people are going to vote for us because of the family legacy we carry. They're going to probably say, अरे इतने सालों में कुछ डेवलपमेंट नहीं हुआ पर इनको वोट कैसे ना दे ये तो पारिवारिक रिश्ता है हमारा. A lot of the key constituencies, if you take a look at Amethi, it's really backward and underdeveloped. And that's probably because the people of Amethi have constantly voted for a family because of their family connect and not because of meritocracy. And therefore, it is essential that we break this bond of people voting under a feudal system. We are no longer a feudal country. We are a democratic country. And therefore, it is very, very essential now that we push meritocracy first into politics and then after politics into every system. Actually, Bollywood, which was always blamed of pushing nepotism, pushing dynasties, has actually started breaking the ranks. Think about it. Some of the best actors that the industry is giving us today are only there because they are able to convince the audiences that they can deliver blockbusters. One of my personal favorites is Kangana Ranaut. She had everything against her. She wasn't from a family. She was somebody who was mocked on because she didn't come from a particular background or lineage. Yet, she made her mark with some remarkable films. I also like Ranbir Kapoor, don't get me wrong. I love Alia Bhatt as well. I think they're fantastic actors. But the great thing about today is that just Ranbir Kapoor or Alia don't survive in this industry. Today, a Rajkumar Rao also has space. Today, a Ranveer Singh has space. Today, a Deepika Padukone has space. And that is because the industry has space for merit. So there are multiplexes that show independent films. There's Netflix, which can show Radhika Apte's work. And there are all kinds of platforms available. The market has grown, and there's space for people to display their merit, to gather audiences, and to make good films, and to succeed. So it's not a bastion of one family, the Kapoor family or the Bhatt family. And that's what we need in politics as well. Why should just 100 or 125 families in this country control all the resources, control all our politics, control everything that's done in this country? 99% of the people, in fact, 99.99% of the people don't even know two generations apart where their family came from. They don't know who their great-great-grandfathers were. They don't know what was done by their great-great-grandfathers, by their ancestors. They are just here because they happen to be born in an ordinary average family just like you and me. And they want to make a mark for themselves. They want to do something for this country. Why should they be denied this right? You know, meritocracy is actually the best antidote against any form of unjust reservation. Reservation for members of one family, reservations for the members of an elite community, reservation for members of certain people who have a certain Lucian's Delhi background, because they speak better English or because they come from a better economic situation. Why should that be the deciding factor in this country? this country should open its doors of opportunities for everybody, no matter where they come from. Why shouldn't a young person from the smallest towns make it big? And cricket is doing that for us as well. Think about it. A lot of our cricketers once upon a time came from Mumbai. They came from the big cities. They came from only places where elite people could afford to buy those expensive kits, go send their children for practice, actually do this kind of stuff and invest their children into sports. But today, the most successful captain India has had is a guy called Mahendra Singh Dhoni. And Mahendra Singh Dhoni came from Ranchi, a small town. Today, we have also got a Virat Kohli who comes from Delhi. And both can coexist. You see, meritocracy has this thing. Meritocracy doesn't push away anybody unfairly. I am not saying that if you happen to be from a certain family, that if you happen to be from a certain background, you don't get space. The constitution of our country gives everybody space. Rahul Gandhi has space, Narendra Modi has space. But if Rahul Gandhi doesn't deliver, then he ought to make space for a Shehzad Poonawalla. If Narendra Modi also doesn't deliver, he has to make space for somebody else. But it can't be that if you don't deliver, you still want to be there. And that's what is something that meritocracy will ensure, that if you don't deliver, you're out of here, just like I'm going to take your leave, and I'm going to tell you that push for meritocracy, and with that message, I'm out of here. Thank you very much.